Hello, welcome to my channel once again. Today too, I am bringing you another video on construction, and I am asking you, do you want to buy a house or you want to build your house yourself? Which one is better? Yes, which one is the best for you to do? I am going to give you some points and you can choose, so that you can choose from all that. So, building or buying? The first point that I'm going to give you is the advantages of building. Number one is if you build your own house, you build to your taste, to what you want, the standard that you want your house to be, or how you want your house to look like, where you want the kitchen to be, where you want the bedroom to be, how many bedrooms that you want. Basically, that's something that the luxury that you get when you decide to build yourself. Another point is you spend less because it is your own building. You are building it yourself. You are not buying, so you spend less. The money that perhaps you are supposed to pay when buying such a property, you are not going to spend that money or that amount of money, so you spend less. My third point is going to be you have the luxury to use the required materials or the desired materials. For instance, you want a particular tile. Yes, but when it comes to the tiles, certain things that you cannot just go and remove. For instance, you see the type of door. You know, there are things that you have the luxury to choose, the desire, things that you actually desire for your work or for your building. You just do that and you are good. My fourth point is going to be building your own house helps you to have the time to just build at your own pace. You build at your own pace. People are building. If you see this building behind me, it's been long, but they are still on it. You have the time. If your finances are right, you come back, you do something small, you go back. When your finances are good, you does it. You see, that is one advantage of you building your own property or your own house. That's a luxury that you get. Now let's go to the disadvantages of you building. The disadvantages of you building: one is you mostly don't get your desired location. In Ghana, for instance, you know, everybody wants to live in perhaps cantonment, East Legon, and all these areas, Ridge, and all that. Those places, as I'm speaking to you now, it's very difficult for you to even get a land in these areas, you understand? But you wish you were living in this area. That is one thing that, as I'm speaking to you now, it will be difficult for you to even get that location. So you will go to a far place to go and do what? Buy a land there and start building, hoping that the place will develop in the future. And some of these disadvantages is that you might buy a land in Ghana, for instance, that you are going to use it for your own house. You are going to build, and after building, the next person or the next person who came to buy the land next to you will be a church or a nightclub. And trust me, those type of regulations in Ghana, the authorities are enforcing those regulations. It doesn't really work like that. So everybody does whatever they want. And these are some of the things that you are going to face. And another disadvantage is it's time consuming, because you know, if you are building, we have processes that you need to go through. You need to go through each process as they come. You don't have to just wake up and say you are building a house or you've built a house. You just need to take your time and do what? And build accordingly. So if you are supposed to use, let's say, a 6 months in building, you need to. If you are supposed to use 1 year in building, you need to. So it's time consuming. You don't get your building up within a twinkle. Yes, so that is also another disadvantage. Now let's go to you buying a property. We all know it takes some few weeks, and the transfer of ownership of the property or of that property will be, everything will be handed to you within some few weeks. all these things will be handed, all the paperwork will be handed over to you. So that is one advantage. You get it fast because the building is already there. All they have to do is the documentation, and that's all. And you can easily do what? Moving into your house. Another advantage is you mostly get your preferred location. For instance, I mentioned Cantonment, East Legon, and all these areas. I'm telling you, currently, there are so many buildings or houses that are being sold in these areas. So you have the opportunity to buy a house at a particular location that you want, or you've dreamt of living the area. So that is also one advantage of you buying a house. My next point is the emotional security. Emotional security is you don't go through all the stress if you buy, or if you are buying, or if you are deciding to buy. You don't go through all the stress. You know, in Ghana, for instance, we have something called the land guards. When you buy your land and after paying and doing all the documentation, you can have some people coming onto your land and being like, you need to pay this to this person, you need to pay this, you need to do this, do that. Trust me, when you decide to buy a house, all these things are not going to, or you are not going to have a problem with all these things. You are not going to have a problem with all these things. So that is one thing that I will also tell you. And also people stealing your materials on site. When you decide to buy, you avoid all these things. You avoid all these things. So that is also one advantage. Now let's go to the disadvantages of you buying a house. When you decide to buy a house, the disadvantages. One, the first one is it is costly. Because it is someone who has built that house and they want to sell it to you. So definitely they are going to do what? Add whatever they are supposed to add and sell it to you. That is their profit. That is their profit. So it's costly. My second point is not building to your taste. Perhaps you want a particular area, so you want to buy a house in this area. Yes, but the building itself, perhaps the way you want your building, or growing up the way you wanted your house to look like, it wouldn't look like how someone decided to build a house, for instance, and sell, would do it exactly the same way you want it. They would do it their way and sell it to you. So you don't get your taste, you don't get what you actually want. That is one point. And you don't know the materials that they used. That's my next point. You don't know the materials that they used. Perhaps they are low standard materials that they used for the building. Sometimes you will not notice it within some few months or few years. Maybe it will be later before you start detecting that they used low materials in building that house for you. You might not know. I'm not saying every company that sells or real estate that sells houses, they use low standard materials. Some do use quality. Yes, some do use quality materials. But I'm just saying that you wouldn't know. You see, that is one disadvantage. And my last point is going to be the financial stress. The financial stress that comes with it. Even if they tell you they want to give it to you within 2 years, perhaps your finances, the work that you do, it doesn't guarantee that you can even pay it within 2 years, you know, but you are forced to pay it within 2 years because, but for instance, if you are building your own house and your finances are some kind of like you are low financially, you can take your time and do what? Perhaps a year, come back and continue. But for this one, they've given you 2 years, so every month you need to pay something. Every month you need to pay something, and it's stressful. It drains you a lot. So these are going to be my pros and cons of you buying a house and you building your house. So you can choose. I will not be the one to say it. Just listen to what I have said and make your decision. I thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.